So 26 years, you've seen a lot of football. What's the what do you think the most effective offensive scheme you've ever seen was?
It's the one that serves your personnel the best. The veer is almost impossible to stop if their linemen are better than yours. Look at Army, Navy, Air Force. When they're good, my God, you can't stop it. So the triple option, if you have triple option people.
In the beginning, most programs utilized mass formations, such as the flying wedge. These formations were created in response to changes made by Walter Camp in the 1880s, which included reducing the number of players on the field and downing the ball. In 1905, when President Theodore Roosevelt called for reforms to football, the forward pass was invented. The first coach to utilize the forward pass effectively was Glenn Pop Warner in 1907 at the Carlisle Indian Academy. Warner created a formation that he could effectively utilize the forward pass out of, which he called the Carlisle formation, which is today known as the single wing formation. This formation has the quarterback lined offset between the guard and the tackle in the backfield, and the fullback and tailback lined up behind the center as the two main receivers to start the play. With Carlisle's use of the single wing, Carlisle lost only one game in 1907 and showcased the effectiveness of the forward pass against Penn, who was undefeated and unscored upon up to that point. The Notre Dame squad of 1913 is often given credit for pioneering the forward pass after a game against Army when Gus DeRays connected with Newt Rockne several times to beat Army 35-13, but it was Carlisle who had pioneered the forward pass years before. Notre Dame, however, did innovate a form of the single wing known as the Notre Dame box. It was created by Newt Rockne, and this formation differed from the single wing because of its balanced line and its unique box-shaped grouping of in the backfield on the strong side. This formation, along with the four horsemen, allowed Notre Dame to be one of the most dominant squads of the 1920s. The single wing continued to dominate until the 1940s when Clark Shaughnessy came up with the T formation. With the T formation, Stanford went 10-0 in 1940 and won the Rose Bowl. His formation featured a balanced line with three backs lined up in a horizontal line behind the quarterback under center. This formation was especially innovative because the quarterback took the snap from directly under center rather than having the ball snapped to the tailback or the fullback, which was common practice. The T formation served as the basis to many other innovative offensive formations as well, such as the wing T formation, which was most notably pioneered by Tubby Raymond at the University of Delaware. Another was the split T formation, created by Missouri coach Don Faroe. Faroe disliked the normal shoulder-to-shoulder alignment and decided that there should be a 12-inch gap between the center and guard, a 2-foot split between the guards and tackles, and a 3-foot split between the tackle and the end. This spread the defense out more, allowing for better reads and bigger lanes. Bud Wilkinson coached under Faroe, who taught him the split T. When Wilkinson became the coach of Oklahoma, he implemented the split T to lead the Sooners to a 4-year, 47-game win streak and 2 national championships in the 1950s.
College was a little different. We were split back veer, which in the 70s, 80s was, made popular by the University of Houston. They were really good in that era, running the split back veer. So it was definitely a little different, which probably helped me, probably fit my skill set a little better. But it still was run, option, play action pass.
Using the T formation as a basis once again, the wishbone was developed in 1968 by assistant coach Emory Bellard while coaching under Darrell Royal at the University of Texas. This formation was extremely effective for running the option. With the wishbone in play, Texas won a national championship in 1969. Many other teams adopted the offense, which became one of the most popular from the 60s to the 80s. During the same time the wishbone was growing in popularity, Coach Tom Osborne of the University of Nebraska Go Huskers was putting his spin on the I formation. Running the option out of the I formation, Osborne led the Huskers to national championships in 1970, 71, 1994, 95, and 1997. Up to this point, many of the innovative offenses were run first. In an attempt to confuse defenses who were used to contending with a strong running attack, some coaches decided to go to the air. Many coaches today who run the modern spread offense or air raid style offenses credit Lavelle Edwards for showing them the ropes. Lavelle Edwards was the head coach at BYU for 30 years from the 70s to the early 2000s. He relied on the run-and-shoot offense, which used Sid Gilman's triangle passing attack to stretch the field vertically, horizontally, and used option routes to allow receivers to adjust their route based on where the defender was. These innovations have served as the basis to many of the high-powered offenses seen in the modern game, such as Mike Leach's mid-2000s Texas Tech offense. I sincerely hope you had as much fun viewing this video as I had making it. Thanks for watching.